May I express my sincere appreciation to the People's Republic of China and the Republic of Namibia for heeding our plea for assistance to alleviate the suffering of our people from the unprecedented effects of flooding this rainy season. Indeed, many lives were lost and damage has been widespread. I am well aware that the People's Republic of China is among some of the countries that experience large-scale severe disasters such as flooding and earthquakes. It is remarkable that the people of China have gained experience to manage disaster risk over time and have in place a robust preparedness and response mechanism which are backed by proactive mitigation strategies, thus ensuring resilience. This ensures continuity and early recovery from calamities. I believe it is opportune for Zimbabwe to glean lessons from this exemplary approach. As you have seen, the People's Republic of China has contributed $1 million to help the government of Zimbabwe to deal with this problem. Ambassador. And it's assistance that is definitely going to be put to good use to really assist the people who have been very badly affected by the floods. And Ambassador, I want to assure you that the money that we have donated will be put to good use. We are so grateful to the Namibians for exploiting their natural resource for the benefit of the people of Zimbabwe. Their natural resource in terms of the abundant fish in the sea, and they felt it is necessary to help people because during these times, food is in short supply and other items, medicines and so forth are in short supply. And a friend indeed comes and says, when it comes to food, here we are giving you some fish to help those who are in desperate need. I thank you very much. As I have said, we are so grateful to the Namibians for exploiting their natural resources for the benefit of the people of Zimbabwe. I should say this magnanimous gesture is a genuine embodiment of the good neighborliness and a reflection of our unique African tradition of Ubuntu. I want to thank you very much, Your Excellency. When we were talking away from this prepared speech, I was saying the relationship between the people of Namibia and the people of Zimbabwe is not only at the political level, it's not only diplomatic, but we have got a blood relationship which says the problem that Zimbabwe faces is the same problem that Namibia faces. If Namibia has got a problem, that problem is also a Zimbabwean problem. So we thank you very much for this assistance. May I now turn to the World Food Programme, who have freely offered warehousing facilities for the consignment of the tinned fish. Sometimes if you receive fish and you don't have proper storage facilities, the fish will go bad. People will eat it and within a short time there's an outbreak of diarrhea and people begin to say, oh, that diarrhea is coming from the fish, and the whole thing turns negative. But when you have got proper storage facilities, then you are sure that the fish will be in good form and it will be good for those who will use it. This has immensely lightened the logistical challenges. We thank you, World Food Program, for your ever-present help on food security programs in Zimbabwe. May I also commend the national and sub-national civil protection structures for their commitment and dedication to duty in ensuring that relief reaches those who are in need. I thank you all for this type of commitment. keep it up. And I want to end by saying this is not an event, it's a process. Assistance will continue to be needed, and we will keep in touch with our friends, Namibia, People's Republic of China, and others, so that, yes, the problem has been here, but as government, as party, we have been able to resolve the problem, and our people will not suffer very much because of the assistance which we are getting from our friends. I want to thank you very much.